talk about stories of transformation, the thing I'm going to talk about today is really a story on my transformation and how I discovered the DNA of place, that very basic mitochondria of what we think about of place. And like all good stories, we have to start at the beginning. And so here we start, at the beginning, where it all began, Milwaukee, Wisconsin, a young man just coming of age, and my parents made me clean the second floor bathroom every Saturday. Now talk about a place. You're like, geez, the bathroom. And I said the exact same thing. So my first transformation of space, that exploration, was turning that second floor bathroom, after it was impeccable, of course, into a restaurant. I made menus, invited my family up. They ordered, I made sandwiches, and served those sandwiches in the bathroom. Now, in that process, of course, I learned two very important things. Context is really important. No matter what kind of sandwich I would make, it was still being served in a bathroom. And on top of it, brand is really important because I named my restaurant the Crap House. And so my challenge, of course, was keeping the restaurant open. It closed the next day. Learned something very, very important about the essence of place in that experience. Fast forward about 15 years, and I had an opportunity to serve my community as an AmeriCorps member in Everett, Washington. Now, in Everett, Washington, I had a great opportunity to work with kids, to work with a wonderful collection of colleagues, but there was one program that really sort of stuck out with me, a moment of zen, if you will, in which we took this sort of dilapidated side of a hill that the entire neighborhood would literally dump stuff. And I tell you, some of the stuff we found would curdle milk. It was nasty, okay? But we started to transform that place into a public park. Now, we started with the group of kids. We started with that Parks and Rec department. But as that space began to get transformed, the neighborhood began to look at their neighborhood differently. They started walking past this park, and they would stop and look at what was a nasty hill that is now being turned into public gardens and pathways. And amazingly enough, the kids actually started showing up on their own and playing music and hanging out. People would come and actually create gardens, and then they would put little placards next to it that talked about what was in the garden. They were actually teaching people what they were planting. It was an incredible transformation of space. And that really stuck with me in that youthful exuberance of AmeriCorps. Now, you kind of fast forward a little bit, and as Brett mentioned, my wife and I had an amazing opportunity to move here to Northwest Arkansas. My first foray into my professional life here was as the executive director of downtown Fayetteville. And it was in that process within downtown Fayetteville that I had a zap moment. I discovered, if you will, a thought process of two gentlemen, Joe Pine and Jim Gilmore, who wrote the book Experience Economy. And it was a zap moment because it actually changed the space in here. It transformed the very way that I thought about how we design communities. It gave me a filter, if you will, to look at communities entirely different because there were two messages that resonated with me. That work is theater, and experience drives value. The zap. There we are. That hand of God came down and touched me on the finger, and I was transformed. So what I realized within the community design paradigm, that oftentimes people either look at use as the driving factor of how they design. They say, well, commercial goes here, residential goes here, industrial goes here, and that ends the conversation. Or the flip side, what they call the evolution of community design, we move into form, the form of a building, the form of the space, and that drives how people design communities. But I began to realize that there was something missing in this conversation, that it was not an either or, but there is a third way of looking at how we design communities. And that is through experience. It is the meshing of use and form, putting that together, and out of that blossoms an experience that people can step into, as we heard earlier, step into that moment and actually participate
in that entire concept of what a community is. Now, how do we do that? What are those elements of the experience? What is that filter? And there are four realms that we talk about. We create experiences in which people can learn. How do you learn about yourself? How do you learn about others? How do you learn about the space you're in? How do we design experiences that literally transport you from one place to another, where literally you step into a space and you feel something different? How do we create experiences where you can just simply be with yourself and with others? Doesn't have to be programmed, that passive space. But how do we entertain people when they walk into a place, that whole concept of experience? So I put this big picture, 36,000 square foot, this filter in which we're now working with and I now work with and how we design places. And let's bring it to some reality. And I want to talk about really quickly the concept of the sweet spot, those indelible places right in the middle. You try to find the sweet spot of all four of those things when you design experience. So I want to talk about the Bentonville Farmers Market, a project that we started working on in 2008. We took over as the Downtown Association in 2008. So how do we learn? We bring chef demonstrations down. People get to learn about our restaurants, our chefs, but they also get to learn how to cook. How to take that crazy bok choy. What is that? I don't know. Well, let's saute it up and turn it into something. How do we transport people? Well, if you've ever been, right around April, the Bentonville Parks and Rec Department basically puts thousands of bulbs of tulips into the ground in winter, and they come up out of the ground right around the opening of the farmer's market. Now, you want to talk about transformation, thousands of points of color. Sort of bring in the farmer's market, but at the same point, transports people from winter into spring. There it goes again. I'm all kinds of excited here. So the next issue is, how do we allow people just to be? Once again, by design, to creating those park benches, those moments of quiet that people can sit in the farmer's market, of course, after buying lots of stuff, and relish in what they purchased. Look around and share in the community of what's happening at the farmer's market. And then we also create an entertainment sector. We bring music in, we bring theater. All of these elements come together into a sweet spot. And our ability to create something in downtown not only has a connection to our farmers and to our community, but it actually reinvents the relationship people have with our downtown square. Now, I want to explain that, as we talked about sustainability, you got to sustain, it's also about cash. And I want to explain this, is that when we took over the market in 2008, they did 90,000 in sales. 2012, we did 540,000 in sales by using this technique of placemaking. So that's me in a hot dog outfit. The other thing that we learned, however, is I have a penchant for dressing up. But the other thing that we learned, which was very interesting, is that you cannot create experiences outside of yourself. You've got to jump right into these things and become a part of it. That's how you design community. You cannot be outside of the community and go, this is what's going to happen. You have to be in there, sleeves up, getting ready to work. Just like the video said, just like the last couple gentlemen talked about, you got to step out. And that's me in a hot dog outfit stepping out. I was facilitating a hot dog eating contest during our July 1st Friday event, the Big Block Party Space. Now that's me in a chicken outfit. All right, I'm doing the chicken dance with over 400 people on the downtown square during our Oktoberfest event. And so you need to step out there, look at the world through that filter, and become a part of the experience you want to create. And so those are my experiment right there, my kids. And I tell you, when I was able to bring those four realms, not just into the community, but into my own home, this transformation that happened in here, how I parent, how I create that space, and of course, in great partnership with my wife, what do we do in our own home? This has been absolutely transformational. And our kids are able to create their own experiences in our home and take that out. And so if there's one thing I can leave you with, it's the opportunity of transformation through experience design. Whether you are transforming your community, your neighborhood, your house, and yes, even a bathroom, to look at those form realms and understand that experience drives value, and that value is both cultural, societal, and economic. Thank you very much for your time.